Yeah, hello, my name is Tobias Kaminski. I'm one of the main and paid developer for the Android app, and I want to show you the next big features of the version 2.0. Just to compare it to the last release, we had 90 pull requests solved in the 4-month development cycle with roughly around 23 solved issues. Now within the same development cycle, we have roughly about 200 pull requests, and it's even growing if we still fix bugs and solved 180 open issues. And as you can see, the blue line marks the version 1.0. We have a really nice and growing overall commit history. The main thing you will see if you open our new app when it will get released is the extended and enhanced drawer icons and drawer items. I just want to present them, the next big features to you. One of the main thing was done by Mario, the other paid Android developer. He completely rewritten the auto upload, so it's now possible to use it for all devices. Previously we had separation between the Android 4 Android 5 and below and Android 6 and above. The old devices still used instant upload, whereas now we can use auto upload for all versions. And we had to do a trade-off between reliability and battery consumption on the one side and instantly on the other side, which was also enforced by the new Android 6, system 6, 7 and 8. So it's now more reliable, or at least it should be 100 reliable, but it's not and will never be instantly because we cannot control when the upload will take, because the Android system will decide this for us. And the next long wished feature was to separate the images and videos so that you can say you want to upload the images right now and the videos only via Wi-Fi. On the drawer you can now directly access the favorited files which are marked on the web UI or on the Android client with a star, and you can just access them directly or directly show the images to your friends, or if it's a note text file you can just edit it. So it's really nice to have the favorites directly accessible. The search function was enhanced. Previously it was mainly filtering on the current folder, but now you can just type in the search bar any search query and you see a result completely from the server, even with external folders. And you can then access and manage them and manipulate them like the normal file listing. This is a feature which is only capable to use with the latest Nextcloud server. If the server admin has enabled the user theming app, you can now see all colors and server name and background images from the server. So you can just distinguish different servers. If you have, for instance, a work server and a private server, you can see by switching your accounts and the color which server you're currently on. And it cannot happen that you just think that any file has been deleted because you are just on the wrong account. So this is image to show three different account types with three different images. And the one on the left has a nice Frankfurt skyline. So notification is something like that will yours present. So I'm just wanted to say that we have integrated it and using it push notification on Google Play devices and polling for all the other apps like F-Droid or if you build it manually. Also you can see the activity stream that you are used to see on the web UI, and also here you can just directly access all the files and access the folders. A big community contribution was to enhance the security, where you can just now use the fingerprint if your device is capable of it and you have set it up. So you can just use it to even more secure the app instead of the PIN, which was just a four-digit PIN. You can just now use your fingerprint. And the last one big thing we have implemented is the new web login flow. You first, if you want to set up an account, you have to enter your server URL. And if it's a server from Nextcloud 12 or above, it will redirect you to the server URL, server login flow of, on the left. We have to enter your username and password. And then it will automatically generate a unique app password and use this for further connections. So if you lost your, or will lose your mobile phone, you can go log in into your web UI and just reset only this session to make sure that the device will never can be connected to the server again. And if either the server is too old or for some other misconfiguration issues, the login will not work. We have still a fallback to the old system. So this is in short the main big features of our 2.0 version. And I want to especially thank the whole community for the great support, either by pull requests or finding bugs or contributing via feature requests or testing the beta versions or the release candidates. So I really big wanted to thank them, because I think otherwise we could never have such a great release without them. Thank you.